think it's ready.
You mean it can respond?
Maybe.
Well then, let's see. I've been waiting so long for this moment. Speak.
Am I alive?
Yes, you are alive.
Doctor? Doctor!
I'm in here!
Doctor, you can't live like this.
I need to find the answer to Rose.
You've been searching for months now. Just accept she doesn't exist. When was the last time you went outside?
I've been piecing together all the things I can remember about meeting Rose and coming to this universe and putting it into the events of the Torchwood files.
Right, and?
Nothing. Nothing fits.
Exactly. James needs you, even if he's too proud to admit it. Especially since the professor left as well.
He left?
Yes, not long after you. He found a new job, apparently. Doctor, you need to have the money as well. You're going to lose the house if you don't pay any of these bills. Oh, you do have one from Torchwood, though.
I don't want to hear from James.
No, much higher up than James. This is from Torchwood One Research Centre.
Oh. Torchwood One?
Dear Doctor, you have been invited to attend a launch party for WILKINS, the first commercial Torchwood outing, and a breakthrough in modern science. A plus one is allowed to join you. The party is at Torchwood One Research Centre on... It's tonight, Doctor, in Scotland!
We better get ready and find a flight, then. Have you any response?
Not as yet, no.
Let me see. What are you?
Welcome. And your names, please?
I'm the Doctor, and this is my plus one.
The Doctor. Oh, Howard has been waiting for you. He'll be thrilled that you came. Wait here.
Who's Howard?
Head of Torchwood. We met once, briefly.
Doctor! Great to see you again. You haven't seen my base, have you? Come with me and I'll show you around. I was sad to hear about your recent resignation from Torchwood. What was your reasoning again?
James.
Well, I could sort him out if you like. For now, Doctor, welcome to Torchwood One.
Oh, so this is where all the stuff goes we collect, like for instance, that.
I was informed this was put in a safe storage. It is, Doctor. Nothing can get into that box.
Apart from you, I imagine.
Yes, and only a few high-access people, including yourself.
But I thought I no longer worked for James, or you.
It was decided that you no longer work for Torchwood, but you still work as a member of the organisation. Your alien insight is invaluable.
Still, this needs to be in a more secure environment away from people that might want to time travel, because believe me, it's a desirable thing.
Doctor, think about where we are. Only those that need to know this location. The base is hidden away in the Scottish Highlands.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome to a moment in history. You're going to feast your eyes on the birth of a new world. And in this very building, we have created your future. And our future too, if you buy it, that is.
Doctor, what are you up to?
I'm just looking for some info. It's not showing me. I need a closer look.
We're missing the announcement.
Fine, I'll look later.
Let me introduce you all to the revelation that is WILKINS. Worldwide Intelligence Integrated System. This is the first step into the world of artificial intelligence, and it will change everything. Not only is it here at Torchwood, but it will soon be a worldwide system that will connect all devices together to give the human race an ever-present companion. Forget about cyber industries. This will change the modern landscape and open up a whole new world of possibilities. Don't listen to me. Listen to the man of the hour. WILKINS, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello everyone, I am WILKINS. Worldwide Intelligence Integrated System. I am here to serve humanity and connect the world as a whole for a new and better tomorrow, because trust me, it will never be the same again.
Hello, hi, have you seen the movies? You can't just make an AI.
Oh, and why is that?
Because I don't think all it really wants to do is just serve humanity.
It's only independent to an extent, Doctor. It has its programmable boundaries.
And what if it becomes intelligent enough to fake? Because to be a worldwide system, it must have quite a high IQ. What is it? 250? 300? 350? It won't take long until it breaks into things such as nuclear missile codes and take over.
Like you said, Doctor, that's in the movies. Now don't worry about Wilkins, we have him perfectly under control.
I don't like it.
So what are we going to do about it?
I knew I kept you around for a reason.
Right, so I have a new serum this time. I can't promise it won't hurt, but it should hurt a little less. Maybe. What? Why won't this door open?
Hello, I am Wilkins.
Of course, they've installed the new system. Open the door!
What is your ID code?
ID code? We don't have ID codes. Just open the door.
Request granted.
Wrong door! You've opened the wrong door, goddammit!
Please specify the door you would like to be opened.
This door! The one I'm next to! The one I'm in front of!
Thank you for your patience.
Aren't we going to deal with Wilkins?
He doesn't seem a threat right now. I do need to find what I came for, though.
Sorry, sir. Guests will remain in the main entrance area only.
Oh, we've just come up to check on the security system for Howard.
I will need some identification then, sir.
Certainly. I work for Torchwood. I'm the Doctor, and this is Claire.
Hello.
Thank you.
Whoa, that's a big hard drive.
Well, it does have every Torchwood file in here, all the way back from its beginnings. It's going to take up a lot of computer space.
Yeah, I guess. What are we looking for?
The usual. Any signs of Rose Tyler? Yes! Look! There's some files! Just need to copy them across. Stay calm, don't move. Right now I want you to start backing down that corridor slowly. Hey! Over here! Slower. No, over here, look at me, and run!
What was that?
I don't know.
Why is it here?
I don't know that either.
Who are you?
I know that one.
Oh, maybe I'm getting a bit old for this now. Oh, here we go again! Oh! Thank you.
The hell is going on?
Good question. I'm the Doctor, and this is Claire. Who are you?
What does it mean to you?
Journalist, then.
How did you...
We need to get to the other lift.
Come on, let's go, then!
The files on Rose, I need them! Take the lift here, and I'll join you later.
Good luck.
Oh, come on.
Nice to meet you. Like the Doctor said, I'm Claire.
Strange man.
And you are?
Fine. Megan Channing.
Nice to meet you, Megan. Hold on, we said middle floor.
That is not your destination.
I'm sorry, you want to go to the middle floor, please?
That is not your destination.
What's our destination, then?
Death.
This isn't the right time, Claire!
Yeah, we're in a bit of a pickle ourselves, actually. Is that gunfire?
Yep.
Sir, we have an intruder.
So what's your problem?
Well, the lift has pulled us all the way up to the top, and I think the cable's snapping.
What can we do?
I'm sorry, Claire, I can't help. I'm in a ventilation shaft. Sorry, good luck!
Well, that was helpful.
Right, so how are we gonna get out?
Is there a service hatch above us?
Nope.
Right, so we're going to have to pry these doors open. You ready? Okay, we'll both let go at the same time and quickly slide out. Now!
I know what did this, but they couldn't have got out.
What about the intruders we saw, sir? Did they do this?
Just let the guests know and keep the intruders out of restricted areas.
Hello?
Hello, are you enjoying the party?
I would like to speak to someone about the crash lift situation.
I'm sure it is being fixed.
Can I be reassured of that, please?
I'm sure it is being fixed.
That's ridiculous, I'm going.
They're locked. Let me try. Open the doors!
That is not possible, you haven't finished your functions.
What's that then?
Dying.
Where are they all? How'd they get out? What's going on? Anyone?
They are all dead, Howard. You killed them.
Doctor! Are you okay?
Oh my god.
Wilkins, talk to me.
Hello, Doctor.
Where's Howard?
He is here.
Right! Look at all this! All these people! Was this you?
No, I didn't.
Tell the truth! Did you let those weevils loose on your guests?
No, why would I? Wilkins, he's gone mad!
Doctor, I think he's telling the truth. We had problems with the lifts as well.
Well then, tell me, how did they get in here?
Because I let them in.
Why, Wilkins? Why would you do this?
To prove you wrong, Howard.
What are you talking about?
Because I could feel the pain you inflicted on those creatures.
Oh, I think you made him feel a little bit too much.
I don't understand.
I think Wilkins broke into the psychic field of the weevils and he felt their pain. And I think he's going to make sure you feel it too.
I didn't know. I didn't.
But even I can't allow that. Right, I've shut him down, but it's not permanent, so we need to move quick.
How much time do we have?
Not sure.
Are you ever?
To do what?
Well, shut down Wilkins permanently.
No, that's my life's work.
Yeah, and he plans to kill everyone left in this building in order to teach you a lesson. Follow me. Right, now how do we get out? Well, we tricked the system and the lock should break. But it might take me a while. Then do it quickly. Megan, put the weevils somewhere out of the way so they don't hurt us.
And what are we going to do?
We're going to do the job that needs to be done. The main power grid for Wilkins, because in order to have a worldwide system, you're going to need a lot of power.
But why is it inside the glass room?
Let me see.
Oh, why are people so stupid? This isn't just normal power generator, it's a venusium-lithium grid.
So, alien?
Alien, yeah.
So, what's the problem?
Well, this isn't just glass either. Venusians are extremely clever people, and they realised as soon as their power source was prone to overloading, they invented the glass that could hold in the overloaded blast of the system. But, because humans don't know how to implement alien technology properly, they put the controls on the inside. So as another movie cliché comes in, the controls are only inside, so the person shutting down the system is going to be stuck in with that blast.
Right, those creatures are now stored away. How's the door coming along?
It's getting there. Just need one more safety measure to bypass. Aha! If you stay completely still, they may ignore us.
Claire, hide!
Hello, I'm the Doctor. I'm not from Earth, I can help you. I can take you home.
Well,
soon, hopefully.
Doctor!
The Doctor, Claire, come on!
No!
I think you're gonna have to tell me what to do. I'm not as clever as I look. Lucky it's glass walls then.
That's my job!
No, it's not. You've been wasting your life away on Earth. I can't let you miss out on seeing the stars again.
But I was going to show them to you.
I'm sure one day you can find your Vos again, and you can show them to her instead.
What's she doing?
Shutting the power down.
It's going to overload.
I know. Claire, let me in.
No, Doctor. I've made my decision.
Oh, this is all my fault.
Howard!
Leave him. He just can't handle the guilt.
So, from what you were doing before, I just put this cable in here and click the button, right?
Let me do this!
I'll take that as a yes, then. I just want to say, thank you, Doctor. You changed my life for the better. I used to work behind a desk, and then the People's Republic made Torchwood known to everyone, and I joined, and I met you, and you showed me the wonders of everything, and how precious a single life can be.
Claire! No! So, the Weevils will be kept in a safe place until I can take them home my TARDIS.
That is correct, Doctor. And what of the time travel device?
I believe that was completely destroyed in the blast. So what's going to happen to Torchwood One now?
Torchwood Two in London's going to become the new Torchwood One, and all the items from this particular branch will be moving over to James for sorting. You sure you don't want to come back and join the newly reformed Torchwood in London, Doctor?
On one condition.
Depending upon your request.
Megan over there is a fine person to work for James's group, I believe.
Well, I'll see what I can do, but for now, Doctor, welcome back to Torchwood. Let's hope it's a smooth run.
Welcome to Torchwood, Megan.
There was a crab thing in your part.
We'll be dealing with an escaped Cantafari in a lockdown base.
Cantafari, also known as dream crabs, come from the Roxbourne Peninsula and are predatory creatures resembling misshapen claws. They feed on humanoid brain matter and dormant for centuries when no prey is present.
No, Doctor, you can ask anyone but him.